Viewers, once again, you are welcome to Better Faith e-learning platform. My name is Mrs. Eunice Egwasa, and this morning I'm going to be teaching you English language for basic 3 and primary 3 classes. Please get your writing materials, settle down quickly as you take a ride. Good. Today we're looking at the topic conditional sentences expressing desires and wishes that are unlikely to be fulfilled. Let me take it again. The topic is conditional sentences expressing desires and wishes that are unlikely to be fulfilled. Conditional sentences from the word condition. When you say condition, I'm sure you've heard of that word before. When you say condition, it means there is something you have to do in order for you to get a particular result. That is a condition. Something that must be strictly adhered to. Something that must be done in order for you to get what you want. So that is it. Conditional sentences express a desire, hope, or plan that still can happen or not. It may happen, it may not happen. And the word would is used to express something that will happen in the future. The word would is futuristic. It's a word you use to express a future occurrence, a future thing, a future desire. Alright. And it begins with the word if, if. If is a conditional word. If. Do not forget, if is different from when. When you say if, it means it is a conditional word. It may happen, it may not happen. But when you say when, that means it's a word of certainty. You are very sure that it's going to happen. I hope you remember that. Good. So the word if is used to begin a conditional sentence most times. Why the result clause begins with the word will. The result clause begins with the word will, would, or would have. I take it again. It begins with the word if. Why the result clause begins with the word will, would, or would have. Examples given. Number one. If I had slept better last night, I would not be tired now. If I had slept better last night, I would not be tired now. That means you are tired now. If you had slept better, you would not be tired now. Do you understand that? Good. I wish Helen could have come. That means Ellen did not come. I wish it's a desire, a futuristic word. Something you hope. Something you hope for. Something you're looking forward to. So I wish Helen could have come. It's a futuristic word. Good. So we're going to quickly take it again. Please pay close attention this time. I said conditional sentences express a desire, hope, or plan that still can happen or not. It may happen or it may not happen. The word would is used to express something that will happen in the future. It begins with if. Why the result clause begins with will, would, or would have. Examples given. Number one, if I had slept well last night, or if I had slept better last night, I would not be tired now. I wish Helen could have come. So let's quickly move to the next structure on the board, which is past participle verbs. Past participle verbs. Do not forget, verbs are action words or doing words. Okay? Good. The past participle is often used when we want to express a passive action. Examples. Number one, he has forgotten the pen. The word forgotten, that is the past participle, from the word forget. Forget is an action word, a doing word. So the past participle of that verb, forget, is forgotten. He has forgotten the pencil. So the underlined word is the past participle verb. Number two, a house was built. A house was built. From the word build, to build is an action verb, it's a verb. So the past participle of that word is built. When you say past, something that is that has happened, something that is past, something you've done before, an event that has occurred before. That is why the past participle of the verb forgotten, that's why it's forgotten. Instead of forget, it's forgotten. Instead of build, is built. The next is the present continuous verbs. When you say present, it means it is in the now. Something that is happening now. And when you say continuous, that means it is still happening. It is still happening. The present continuous tense is formed from the present tense of the verb be and the present participle, ing form of a verb. I take it again. So the present continuous tense is formed from the present tense of the verb be and the present participle, ing form of a verb. That means when you add ing to a particular doing word or a particular action word, that means that particular act is still going on at the moment. Hope you got it. Because we are talking about present continuous. It is still going on at the moment. That is why ing is added to the verb. Example one. And don't forget, this am is the constricted form of I am. It is the same as I am. Okay? I'm just leaving work. I'll be home in an hour. I'm just leaving work. I'll be home in an hour. That means perhaps it was a phone call and the speaker is telling whoever called that he or she is just leaving work. That means the person is just leaving at the moment. I'll be home in an hour. That is a present continuous verb. Example two. At 8 o'clock, we are usually having breakfast. At 8 o'clock, we are usually having breakfast. That means it is a present continuous verb. The word having, not have, but having, that means it's a continuous act or a continuous action. It is happening at that moment. At 8 o'clock, we are usually having breakfast. Good. Listen as I take it again. Past participle verbs. When you say past, it's an event that has happened before. The past participle often used when we want to express a passive action. E.g., when you say passive action, do not forget, passive, we have passive and we have active. Active means the speaker is involved. The speaker is the one. You know, a sentence is made up of the subject and the predicate. So the speaker at the moment is the one carrying out the action. But when you say passive, that means the speaker is not involved. Okay? Good. He has forgotten the pencil. He has forgotten the pencil. So the word forgotten is the participle of a verb of that particular sentence. Example two. sentence. Then we move quickly to present continuous verbs. I said present means something that is happening in the now, something that is happening presently. And continuous means it is ongoing, it is going on at the moment. So the present continuous tense is formed from the present tense of the verb be and the present participle ing form, ing. When you see ing attached to a verb, that means it is ongoing, it is going on at the moment. Example one, I'm just leaving work. I'll be home in an hour. The word leaving is the present continuous verb. Example two, at 8 o'clock, we are usually having breakfast. The word having is the present continuous verb of the sentence. I hope you got that. I hope it is clear to you. So please, when you make your sentences, always make proper use of the right tense. Otherwise, the intention that you have will be misunderstood. So when you make your sentences, make sure you look out for the right tense of the verb. Okay? Good. You know, like I always say, practice makes perfect. It isn't good for you to learn and then you just close your books and you play away. But it is proper for you to practice what you have learned this morning. So please, our practice exercise. Quickly, we are going to look at our practice exercises. Please and please, make sure you do them on your own. Underline the following in the sentences. You have to underline the following in the sentences. Good. Number one, the conditional sentences. Remember I taught you the conditional sentences. So you are going to underline in these two questions the conditional sentence in the word, in the sentence. Number one, or A, James ran, otherwise he would have missed the bus. James ran, otherwise he would have missed the bus. So you have to underline the conditional sentence there. B, it is snowing. I wish it would stop. It is snowing. I wish it would stop. So you have to underline the conditional sentence in that particular sentence. Number two, you have to underline the past participle verbs in these two sentences. Sentence A, the shoe bought yesterday is blue. The shoe bought yesterday is blue. So you have to underline the past participle of that sentence. Sentence B, look at the washed car. Look at the washed car. You have to underline the past participle verb in that sentence. Number three, the present continuous verb. You have to underline the present continuous verb in these two sentences. Sentence A and sentence B. I'm working in London in the next 2 weeks. I'm working in London in the next 2 weeks. Underline the present continuous verbs. Question B. Please be quiet. The children are sleeping. Please be quiet. The children are sleeping. You have to underline the present continuous verb in these two sentences as well. Altogether, you have 6 sentences to work on as your practice exercise. Please and please, make sure you do this and read your books as well and be good children. Thank you very much.